Hi folks, welcome back to Mad Ferret Studios. Boudicca here. So we are starting part 7 of Boudy and Kaiden's playthrough. We are going to go meet Delphine, or go see Delphine in Riverwood, and then continue on our quest line. Ouch, sorry. Hey, no biting my feet, child. Sorry. One of my ferrets is biting my socks. Anyway, as I was saying, we will be picking back up where we left off on the main quest line. So for now, before we head out, I want to talk to Kaiden a bit. No. Who's going to go to bed? What time is it? Oh, gosh. It is bedtime, isn't it? Now that he slept, I'm going to take a brief nap.
I'm at your service. I was just starting to get cozy.
I'm the innkeeper. It's my business to keep track of... Attic room, eh? Well, we don't have an attic room, but you can have the one on the left. Make yourself at home.
Good afternoon.
We don't get a lot of travelers here in Riverwood. So you're the Dragonborn I've been hearing so much about. I think you're looking for this.
We need to talk.
Follow me. Close the door. Come on, close the door. Now we can talk. The Greybeards seem to think you're the Dragonborn. I hope they're right. I hope so, but you'll forgive me if I don't assume that something's true just because the Greybeards say so. I just handed you the Horn of Jorgen Windcaller. Does that make me Dragonborn too? I didn't go to all this trouble on a whim. I needed to make sure it wasn't a Thalmor trap. I am not your enemy. I already gave you the horn. I'm actually trying to help you. I just need you to hear me out. Like I said in my note, I've heard that you might be Dragonborn. I'm part of a group that's been looking for you. Well, someone like you, for a very long time. If you really are Dragonborn, that is. Before I tell you any more, I need to make sure I can trust you. We remember what most don't, that the Dragonborn is the ultimate dragon slayer. You're the only one that can kill a dragon permanently by devouring its soul. Can you do it? Can you devour a dragon's soul? Good, and you'll have a chance to prove it to me soon enough. Yes, we're very old enemies. And if my suspicions are correct, they might have something to do with the dragons returning. But that isn't important right now. What is important is that you might be Dragonborn. Dragons aren't just coming back. They're coming back to life. They weren't gone somewhere for all these years. They were dead, killed off centuries ago by my predecessors. Now something's happening to bring them back to life, and I need you to help me stop it. I know they are. I visited their ancient burial mounds and found them empty. And I figured out where the next one will come back to life. We're going to go there, and you're going to kill that dragon. If we succeed, I'll tell you anything you want to know. You should know. You got the map for me from Bleak Falls Barrow. The Dragonstone was a map of ancient dragon burial sites. I've looked at which ones are now empty. The pattern is pretty clear. It seems to be spreading from the southeast, down in the Geralds near Riften. The one at Kynesgrove is next, if the pattern holds. Kynesgrove, there's an ancient dragon burial near there. If we can get there before it happens, maybe we'll learn how to stop it.
I need to get into
my traveling gear. Give me a minute and I'll be ready.
It's a good thing dragon slaying is in your blood, eh?
You're right.
All right.
That's better. Let's get on the road.
That feels like a pretty loaded question.
Fair enough. Meant nothing by it.
I was hoping to get a copy of this. You must find it fascinating. The history of your blood. And here at the end is the prophecy. I can only wonder what stories will be written about you.
Ah, it's nothing. Don't you ever mind that.
You just find that lying around? Must be your lucky day.
Yes? Kynesgrove is this way. We can travel together or split up and meet there. Your choice. What is it? Come on, we've got to get to Kynesville.
Thank...
Ah, goodness!
Take a look.
I like it here.
Be careful.
Good evening. Where do you want to go? Climb and back, and we'll be off. Ever been to Windhelm? Oldest city in Skyrim by some accounts. They say the big old palace there was built by Ysgrimor himself.
What are you doing?
dragon! It's attacking! It flew over the town and landed on the old dragon burial mound. I don't know what it's doing up there, but I'm not waiting around to find out.
Come on, hurry. We might be too late.
Freezing my ears off.
Salukunir, zeal grow tova ulsa.
I owe you some answers, don't I?
Starting to feel much better now.
Whoa, easy now.
I owe you some answers, don't I? Go ahead, whatever you want to know. Nothing held back. I'm one of the last members of the Blades. A very long time ago, the Blades were dragon slayers, and we served the Dragonborn, the greatest dragon slayer. For the last 200 years since the last dragonborn emperor, the Blades have been searching for a purpose. Now that dragons are coming back, our purpose is clear again. We need to stop them. Not a damn thing. I was just as surprised as you to find that big black dragon here. Really? Where? Interesting. Same dragon. Damn it! We're blundering around in the dark here. We need to figure out who's behind it all. The first thing we need to do is figure out who's behind the dragons. The Thalmor are our best lead. If they aren't involved, they'll know who is. Before the Great War, the Blades helped the Empire against the Thalmor. Our Grandmaster saw them as the greatest threat to Tamriel. At the time, that was true. Maybe it still is. So we fought them in the shadows, all across Tamriel. We thought we were more than a match for them. We were wrong. Nothing solid, yet. But my gut tells me it can't be anybody else. The Empire had captured Ulfric. The war was basically over. Then a dragon attacks, Ulfric escapes, and the war is back on. And now the dragons are attacking everywhere, indiscriminately. Skyrim is weakened. The Empire is weakened. Who else gains from that but the Thalmor? If we could get into the Thalmor embassy, it's the center of their operations in Skyrim. Problem is, that place is locked up tighter than a miser's purse. They could teach me a few things about paranoia. I'm not sure yet. I have a few ideas, but I'll need some time to pull things together. Meet me back in Riverwood. If I'm not back when you get there, wait for me. I shouldn't be long. Keep an eye on the sky. This is only going to get worse.
So, Delphine is a Blade. In which case, I can't really blame her for being so elusive. I wouldn't mind picking a brain if I get the chance.
All right.
Nothing important.
Aye. I've heard this story before, from Brynjar. Be interesting to read it now, knowing what I do about the Blades. They had a few unique fighting styles, you know. Let me show you a move or two. I've got your back. Word is, the waters here are good for you. The smell? Not so much. But the waters? Yeah. Beautiful day.
If you bring mead, you're welcome here. Ah, even if you don't, you're still welcome. Yes, I've wandered a bit, but I always come back to Kynesgrove. My clan was one of the first to settle here. Legend says that my forefather, Lena, discovered the mines after he stumbled into a dark cave to relieve himself.
Too much mead.
Of course, there's another story of Lena losing the family shield in a different cave. So it depends on who you believe. According to my grandfather, at least, he swore that version of the legend was true. Even found the cave old Lena stumbled into. If you find it, I could show you some of the clan's favorite fighting moves. They're all shield techniques. Well, a lifetime of study, you might say. The best comes from Riftwood, but I haven't been there in years. Ever tried making your own? It's not easy, trust me. Hopefully that story about Lena's shield is true.
Here for work? Get an axe and bring me... Seen the remnants of the grove? That? Well, that was me. Me and my sister.
Did you see my husband?
Poor Rogi. If you're feeling charitable, buy the Nord a mead. He's good for it. He's been in Kynesgrove forever. Great storyteller. Keeps everyone's spirits up. Owes me a lot of coin for drinks. I keep telling him not to worry about it, but he's got the stubborn Nord blood. Damn fool doesn't have the coin to pay me back, so he just beats himself up over it, and then he gets thirsty and it cycles all over again. If you could convince him that I don't care about his tab, it'd certainly make me feel better. People say there's someone in Riften that can change your face, make you look completely different. Do you believe that? Of course. It's all in this note. I hope you'll stay for a... Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Everything all right?
Hell yeah!
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
I visited the meadery, working our mine. What do you think I am? A beggar? My family has always paid back every single coin we owed, going back to Tiber Septim's time. I guess you're right. A Nord shouldn't be so proud to turn down a kind soul's generosity. Tell Idra I'll be fine. Good day.
I hope you'll stay for a bit. Well, this is really quite a nice town when you get down to it. It'll be good to not have to hear him whining about his debts. Rogi pawned a few of his things back when he still had things to pawn. Take them. Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry. Good luck out there.
An outsider? No reason to stop in Kynesgrove. Keep moving. The mine's always on the verge of collapse. Good thing I'm around to keep it up. Nosy one, huh? I was a mage back in Morrowind. I lend my talents to the mines here, helping them keep the tunnels safe. By Azura, it gets hot in there. I use frost salts for a potion to keep the heat bearable, but I'm out. If you want to go to the trouble, feel free. I suppose I could offer you a bit of free alteration training when you get back. Safe travels.
Hello there. I usually just break the locks off some of those chests. But your way seems a bit more elegant.
I'm ready. Let's go.
have retrieved the Horn of Jorgen Windcaller. Well done. You have now passed all the trials. Come with me. It is time for us to recognize you formally as Dragonborn. You are ready to learn the final word of unrelenting force. Da, which means push. Three words together, this shout is much more powerful. Use it wisely. Speak to you. Stand between us and prepare yourself. Few can withstand the unbridled voice of the Greybeards, but you are ready.
Ingra Rossis Saran Strundul Oth Ibala Tho Ran Now.
Ysmir, Dragon of the North.
You're sure entertaining with those honeyed words. Feel free to weave me a story, or sing me a song, any time. Aye. It is strange that they would ride in dragon. And not Akaviri. Can you translate it? I appreciate. Just don't burn yourself out over it. I've heard about a rare book written on the subject too. Dragon language, myth no more. There may be others like it we can look out for. Aye. That's what the Thalmor kept suggesting too. It had me thinking. If this sword really belonged to my mother, could it mean she may have been part of that order? It might explain Brynjar's secrecy, seeing how they and everyone connected to them were hunted down. Of course, it could also have just been one in a game of dice.
Aye.
Thank you.
care. Leave me alone.
I don't have time for this foolishness. Now come along quietly.
Have a death wish?
Alright folks, I think we're gonna call it there. I kind of lost track of where I was gonna go until we ran into the bandits, so thanks for joining me on this mission. Please like and subscribe, and we will catch up with Delphine and other adventurers in between.